Now, this is a product that I was absolutely hype on, but I'm so kind of like torn on right now. I've used these so much. It is the BASN smart cable adapter. And what that does is it turns your MMCX connector into a wireless headset. Now that's pretty cool because a lot of the balanced armature headphones that you have that are like high-end professional ones, they actually use that connector. So being able to have that connector and then being able to actually like, you know, be wireless is dope. I was waiting for something like this. I've seen some like things in the past where they look kind of like, you know, shady, but this one coming from BASN and me having a good experience from my BASN headset last, I thought maybe these might be pretty good. So I decided to check it out. It fits around your neck like this. You know, that's how it rests around your ear. Pick it up and you put it in your ear. So you're walking around looking like this. So I don't know, I mean, it doesn't look ridiculous. It looks fine. Even from the side, it looks fine, right? Okay, it works, it's cool. It gets the job done, right? All right, cool. I use these when I'm like outside doing yard work, cutting grass, building stuff or whatever. And what I noticed about these was the plastic sound. The build quality, as you can hear, isn't all that. It's got this weird loose plastic sound. Weird as in the word cheap, but you know, these didn't cost too much. So that's probably why. They've also got microphones inside of the connectors too. So if you didn't have a cable that had a microphone in your last headset for these MMCX connectors, then now you've got the ability to take a phone call as well. It's got a volume up and a volume down. It's got a power button where you can also pause and play, which is cool. Answer calls and stuff like that, which is cool. It's also got this weird string thing that it lets you extend how much you need this thing to be. It's kind of annoying because you have to put it on you a certain way with the string thing pointed up, and if it's pointed down, it's not gonna fit right, but it's one of those things, man. You just kind of have to pay attention. You can't just put this on and just go. You have to make sure you got the left side on, the right side on, and you're good. That's an important thing. Let me show you how these pop right off. So here's the connector. And then if I want this off, it's off. So that's the MMCX connector. And you've seen this on a lot of like Ultimate Ears and high-end earbuds like Shure and stuff like that. I did try these with the Ultimate Ears and I'm gonna tell you that the UE900s don't sound like they're getting enough power for this unit. They sound underpowered. So the bass wasn't really there. The clarity was fine, but the bass wasn't there. So it wasn't as enjoyable as the wired experience. So those, I've kept them as my wired go-to. I haven't really messed with those. With the BASN headsets though, these actually sound really, really, really good on this. They sound just as good as the wired ones, which was very surprising. You know, sometimes you think going Bluetooth, you're gonna lose some sound quality, but nah, with this, it sounds pretty accurate. But these earbuds already sounded really good for the price. They're great. So just getting this adapter with this definitely helped. And honestly, I haven't plugged these things back into the wires yet. They've been on this wireless adapter. This adapter also charges with a micro USB. So if you've got like a cell phone that is still using micro USB, or if you've got some micro USB adapters left over, then you know, you're not gonna have any problems plugging it in right here. That's gonna work. The lifespan on the unit is pretty good. I'd say probably about 10 hours of listening on the average. I've only charged them up maybe like 3 or 4 times, but I've used them quite a bit. So, and on standby, like if you just leave them alone, the battery still holds a charge, which is also a good thing to know when you're dealing with headsets, when you want to grab it and go, you don't want to think about it too much. There are some things going on here, which I'm not sure if it's, well, no, I should be honest. I think it's this thing. There is some Bluetooth drops, and I normally get that when like I'm mowing the grass or something like that, where it's dropping in and out depending on where I move my head. Or some certain things, for some reason, some of the stuff drops in here. And this isn't the first headset that's done that. I also had another headset that did that too, another Bluetooth headset that did that. But it's annoying because you can't really fix it. So I can't really figure out the true source of it. I don't know if it's because of my phone. and the power of the Bluetooth from my phone, that transmitter or what, but it does it. It definitely does it. On my laptop, when I connect my Bluetooth to my laptop, it actually sounds really good too. So, you know, I don't get any drops there, but for the most part, it's a good listening experience when it works. Also, I had some connector issues before with the BASN headsets. After a while, it felt like the connectors were coming loose. So sometimes when it twists certain ways, it would actually drop the audio in that particular ear. And that is something that this does too. So I don't know if that's the earbud or if that's the connector. I'm gonna probably say it's the earbud because it's happened on the wired ones too, on the wired connectors too. So I'm not gonna blame this, but it is something to note with the BASN product that I have that I'm experiencing that. But overall, I'd say it's an enjoyable experience and it works most of the time. So definitely would recommend it so far. So I got this connector for like $50. It was $49.99 on Amazon when I bought it, and I don't regret buying it. I actually bought it the same day I bought the KZs from Linsol, and maybe that's the reason why I just had a lower tolerance for the KZs, because they really were horrible. But this connector really was cool. It was really nice. I mean, I didn't think it was going to work as good as it worked, but I'm glad it worked. I wish that maybe the build quality was better instead of this plasticky sound. But on build quality, I'm gonna give it a 3, because I don't believe that this will actually hold up because of the plastic sound and the plastic build of this. I don't think it's gonna hold up with everyday use. It's really hard to protect this thing. So I'm definitely gonna give it like a 3 on build quality. I feel like if it was metal or just maybe tighter fitting plastic pieces with less jiggles, it would be better. As far as sound quality goes, I'm gonna give it a 5. I've enjoyed listening to a lot of different things with it, and it sounded better than I thought it would sound. So I thought it was gonna sound kind of like a little lackluster, but it didn't. It actually sounded really good, and the audio controls work well, the volume up and down works, and all the buttons work, and the microphone actually works too. It works really well too. So I'm gonna give it a 5 out of 5. It's definitely met. It surpassed my expectations because the quality was there. So would I recommend you buy this? If you've already got some earphones with the MMCX connector and they're wired and you wanna have the ability to go wireless, then I recommend you try it out if you've got the money to spend. I think as it stands today, I recently got some new earbuds, and those kind of changed the game for me a little bit. So I haven't actually been using these as much as I've been using my new ones, which I'm gonna do a quick review on too. So I would say that probably pass on these. You don't really need them. You may be better off with some of the newer Bluetooth offerings that are coming out. I think those will actually be more bang for your buck than these at $50.